Now, this is a video I've been really excited about filming because in this one, we're going to show you how to paint the Custodian Guard, the Emperor's personal bodyguard and the very finest of warriors that humanity has to offer. Now, at the burning of Prospero, they were the symbol of the Emperor's authority and power, and the miniatures certainly show this from the sheer amount of detail etched into their armour. So let's waste no more time, go and grab your paint and let's get to it. As the armour of a Custodian Guard is almost entirely gold, we're going to start out by painting that. And the base colour for this is going to be Retributor Armour. Now, as always, remember to give all your paints a good shake before you use them, especially with your metallics. And I'm going to be applying this with a large base brush because we want to paint on so much of it. Now, I always use a palette when I'm painting because it's really useful for helping control your paint. It's always a good idea to get some of the paint and put it on there because doing so means I can now thin it down with a small amount of water. You don't need loads, but doing so just means the paint dries a bit smoother, goes a bit further as well, and it also helps avoid clogging up any details by just being a bit thinner, you see. You're looking for about that kind of consistency, then make sure you're not applying too much at once, so just get rid of some excess paint off your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is paint this all over your Custodian onto his gold armour. Now, I am going to be applying two thin coats this colour because as I put it on here, you can still see some of the Chaos Black spray undercoat showing through. It's not a problem, so long as you let the first coat dry before you add the second, you'll get a much stronger gold that way before you move on to the next stage. I finished applying the second coat, and now that the Custodes is completely gold, we're ready for the next step, which is to add some shade to give the model some depth. And for this, we're going to use Reichlin Flesh Shade, which will give us a nice warm gold in the end. I'm going to be applying it using my medium shade brush. And once again, what you want to do here is make use of your palette to build a good little puddle of this colour on here, so you control exactly how much of this you have on the brush at once. Get plenty on there, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting this all over the gold that you've done so far. And you'll see as soon as I start painting on, it immediately settles into all the recesses and gives us some really nice shading. So what you need to do now is paint this all over your miniature and then give it about an hour to dry. But as it's drying, to keep an eye on it to make sure the shade isn't pooling too much towards the bottom of the miniature. The shade's now completely dry, and you can see just what a difference it's made by settling into all that recess detail and helping all the details pop out nicely. And now we're ready to start highlighting the miniature, and the first stage of doing that is going to be to layer it using Auric Armor Gold. Now this time I'm going to be using a small layer brush to apply it, and we're going to be much more precise now about where exactly we're putting the paint on. So, as before, use your palette to get the paint under control by thinning it with a small amount of water, and then just make sure you just drag the brush along and twist it like that to bring the bristles to a nice point. And then when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this to the armour, but this time, avoid recessed detail where the shade has settled. So for example, on the shoulder plate here, where we've got this Aquila design, I'm looking at painting this colour on the flatter panels, such as around here, but where that little recess is there, I'm just going to avoid that and paint on the other side there like that to brighten that flatter area up. And again, just avoid that recess there where the shade is and paint that flatter area. So just like this, you just need to carry on now doing this all across the armour, following this technique all the way along as you go. Now the Auric Armor Gold's been applied, the model's much brighter and shinier. We're ready to do our highlight, which is going to be Liberator Gold. Now this I'm going to be applying with my small layer brush once again, and I'm going to be doing an edge highlight this time. And to do that, what you need to do is, again, use your palette to make sure your paint's nice and thin and flowing really easily, and get that good tip on your brush. And what you're looking to do is just pick out all the sharper edges on the armour. Now with these guys, it's actually really good because these edges are really well defined. So if I go back to this shoulder pan I was doing earlier, all I'm going to do is use the corner of my brush, or the side of my brush, to just start picking out those corners there like that, just running it gently along, so we get a nice neat line following along those edges there like that. So all you need to do now is carry on doing this all across the gold armour. With that highlight fully applied, the gold armor's looking fantastic. And well, you could leave it here if you wanted to, but because this warrior is such an elite warrior, we thought it'd be cool just to go a little bit further with highlighting the armor. So if you want to do this, what you need is Stormhost Silver, and we're gonna add a very fine highlight here, almost like a specular highlight. Now to do it, you once again need your small layer brush, and we're gonna be doing another edge highlight with this, but this time we're gonna be much more selective about where exactly we apply it. You really don't need very much here, and what we're looking to do is to pick out the very sharpest details on the armor. So for example, if we go back to this shoulder pauldron once more, I'm looking at things like that top point we've got there, just a small amount of this colour just on that corner, so just around there and there like that, just to bring it out a little bit more like that. So all the time you're looking for these really sharp corners, but be very selective, don't go too far on it because you don't want to overdo this highlight. And with that highlight applied, all the gold details are now complete and we can start painting some other colours. And the first thing we're going to paint is all the parts that are black. Things like the Guardian Spear haft and also pipes and joints, all that kind of thing. And for all this, we're going to base coat with the Baden Black and then highlight using Eschen Grey. But starting out with the Baden Black for this, I'm going to be using my small base brush to begin with, but it's a good idea to have a few different sizes on hand so you can switch around them as you need to. As always, make sure your paint's really thin and smooth. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this to these sections that you want to be black. I'm going to start on the spear just here, and I've got these gold designs on it, so as I apply this, I'm just going to be really careful around those parts, but for the rest of it, I will be applying two thin coats to get a good solid black before we move on to highlighting it. And then use Eshin Grey to wedge highlight all the black using your small layer brush. And with that highlight applied, all the black details are now complete, and we can start base coating in some other colours, which are all actually going to use the same shade, so we can do them all at the same time. We're going to start out by using Doomball Brown to paint all the leather parts, then Leadbelcher for all the parts that are going to be silver, and then we'll finish off with Mephiston Red for all the red details, like the plume, for example. So starting with Doomball Brown, I'm going to be applying this, and in fact all these colours, using a small layer brush. It's a good sized brush for the kind of details we're doing here. As always, make sure your paint's really thin and smooth in the palette, and then make sure you don't have too much of it on your brush at once. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this to all these details. I'm going to start on these other straps just down here, and I will be applying two thin coats this colour to get to a good strong point before we move on to the next one. But just remember to be really neat as you're working around all the gold that we've completed so far. Next, base coat all the silver details using Leadbelcher, such as the faceplate here. And remember, when you're doing this detail, just be really careful because there's a lot of tricky detail to get to around here. So just be as neat as you can as you apply this colour. And then base coat all the red details using Mephiston Red, and with this colour you'll need to apply two thin coats. With all those colours established, we're now ready to shade them, and all of them are going to use Norn Oil. Now for this time we're using the shade, I'm going to use my small layer brush to apply it, because we've got to be much more controlled about where exactly we're putting it this time. So really use your palette to gauge how much exactly you have on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is paint this directly over the leather, the red, and also the silver as well. Now as you're applying it, you want a good even coat like I'm getting here, but just remember to be really careful as you get close to that gold so you don't get any of this shade on the armoured details there. Once the Norn Oil is completely dry, we're now ready to move on to finishing off those colours all in turn. We're going to be highlighting all of them, and like with the armour, we're going to go just a little bit further than normal because these models are so special. I'm going to start by highlighting all the leather parts with Wazdaka Red first of all, then a very fine highlight of Squig Orange. Then we'll highlight all the silver parts by using Stormhost Silver, then finally the red parts we're going to highlight first of all with Evilson Scarlet, then a very fine amount of Wild Rider Red to finish them off. But starting with Wazdaka Red, I'm still using my small layer brush, and we're going to do some edge highlighting here. So as before, use your palette to get your paint ready, and once you've done that, all you're looking to do is to pick out all the sharpest parts of these details. So I'm going to start on these leather straps just down here, and I'm looking to follow all the edges that are along these parts here. So just as neatly as possible, pick those parts out, just taking your time as you do so. And then add a fine highlight to all the leather using Squig Orange, just focusing on all the very sharpest edges. Next, use Stormhost Silver to highlight all the silver details, such as these little parts we've got down here. And whilst you're using this colour as well, apply a layer of it over all the gems in preparation for when we complete these details later on. Now we're ready to highlight all the red parts, and I'm going to start with the plume here, still with a small layer brush. And what you can do here is if you use the side of your brush and just gently run it along like that, you catch just the red strands really easily. So you just need to carry on doing this now on all the red details. And with that Evilson Scarlet applied, all we need now is Wild Rider Red to finish off the red, just lightly applied, just gently like this along the top of the plume, and I'm going to do a bit towards the end of it as well. With those highlights applied, the Custodian Guard is nearly complete. There's just a few small details left to do, and the first of these we're going to finish is painting all the gems. Now we've already painted those with Stormhost Silver, and all we need is Soulstone Blue to complete them. And to apply this paint, it's a little bit different from normal. What you need is, once again, your small layer brush, but for this paint instead, what you do is just get a little dollop of it on the end of your brush there like that. You don't need very much. And when you're ready, all you do is pick the gem that you're going to start with, so I'm going to begin with this one just here, and you apply this towards the bottom left of the gem, and then pull it up towards the top right. So you're looking to make the colour darker towards the top right by having more of it there. Now that the gems are done, we're ready for the next detail, which is going to be the eye lenses. And to do this, you just need two colours. First of all, we're going to use some white scar, and then we'll glaze over it using Bloodletter. But starting with white scar, this time I'm going to use an extra small artificer layer brush, because the eye lenses on these miniatures are very small, so I want as much control as possible here. Make sure your paint's really thin and flowing really easily. And then what we're looking to do is to paint a line of this colour directly in the centre of each eye lens. So what you need to do is just brace your hands with the miniature as steady as possible. When you're ready, just paint a thin line right in the middle of the eye, there like that. And then apply a small amount of Bloodletter into the recess of the eye lens, still using your extra small artificer layer brush. Now that the eyes are complete, we just have one detail left to paint, and that's the blade of the Guardian Spear. Now, because this weapon's such a signature part of the Custodes, we thought it'd be cool to go for a really cool effect that you can see on the box, so that lightning-shrouded, energized blade. Now, to do this, what you need, first of all, is Cantor Blue for the base coat, then we're going to layer using some Sotek Green. Now, for that, we'll use Temple Guard Blue, then shade over it with Drakenhof Nightshade, then go back to Temple Guard Blue briefly, and then use White Scar to finish it off with a fine highlight. So starting then with Cantor Blue, I'm going to go for a medium layer brush for this, and if you're doing a Sentinel Blade, you can of course paint this in the same way, following the same steps. Starting with Cantor Blue, once it's nice and smooth, make sure you haven't got too much on your brush, and all you have to do is base coat this across the entirety of the blade. Now it's important that you get a good strong colour before you move on to the next stage, so I will be applying two thin coats. Next, apply a thinned layer of Sotek Green using your small layer brush. And for this, what you're looking to do is paint this flat part of the blade just along here. But where you've got that angle running down the centre of it, leave that with the darker blue showing and just paint some more of this on the other side of it there like that. Next, we're going to apply some thinned down Temple Guard Blue. And this time, what we're looking to do is an edge highlight running across the edge of the blade. And also, we're painting a line of this just running across just this area here, but this time I want the highlight to be just a little bit thicker than normal, so once you've applied it, just bring it a small way onto the flat of the blade. Now those colours are applied, I just want to darken them all down a little bit, so I'm going to apply a thin coat of Drakenhof Nightshade applied with my medium layer brush. With the shade completely dry, we're now going back to Temple Guard Blue, but this time we're applying it as just a very fine edge highlight, but along those same lines that we applied it earlier. So remember, just the edge of the blade, and also that line partway down the blade as well. And then add a fine highlight of White Scar. You don't need very much of this. Instead, what you want to do is just focus it along the curvature of the blade, so just very lightly, along there like that, going up to the tip of it, and then just put a small amount on the sharpest corners. So just a little bit up there, this little corner just down here. And also you want to look at applying some just to this little corner just here. With the White Scar applied, the blade is looking really cool, and you could leave it here if you wanted to. But if you want to add that energy effect of lightning all over it, what you need to do is go back to Temple Guard Blue, this time with an extra small artificer layer brush, and paint this on as a series of short, sharp, straight lines running all across the blade. Then trace over this pattern using White Scar, thin down once again. You don't have to catch every line that you did previously, but it just adds a bit of variety to the colour and gives you a few little sharper, brighter parts along it. And once done this, well, all you got to do is base your miniature, and as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. There we are, the Custodian Guard is complete, resplendent in his golden armour and ready to go and take the vengeance of the Emperor to the traitors. So when you're painting these miniatures, remember when you're applying that initial base coat of Retributor armour, always apply it as multiple thin coats because it's very important you get it nice and even, nice and bright, and also avoid clogging up all the intricate detail on the armour. Then when you apply the all-over shade of Reichlam Flesh Shade, remember to keep an eye on it as it dries to make sure it doesn't all run and pool towards the bottom of the miniature. If it does, just move away the excess paint with your brush. When you move on to your highlights, really take your time and be as neat as you can, because the better those highlights are, the better the final result of the miniature is going to be. And finally, if you decide to paint the powered blade like how we did in this video, then remember to keep your layer paints really thin to ensure you get a nice, even, smooth transition from one colour to another. And there you go, that's all there is to it. Now, we really hope that you guys have fun painting your Custodian Guard and, of course, crushing your enemies with them. We'll see you again very soon. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials. And in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?